Hello everyone, this is Mehreen Hashmi with another artist talk with Sana Durrani. Sana Durrani is an artist from Lahore and you are watching Behind the Art Scene. So in this Behind the Art Scene, I either invite artists or I show you what's happening in art scene and what's the news and different topics about related with artist art scenes and artist community of Pakistan and also my fellow artists from abroad as well. So if you have not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe to my channel and I'm going to invite my guest Sana Durrani, who is an art restorer. She is an artist as well. She works in Lahore Arts Council and she has been doing a lot of things with this project. Otherwise, there was a video about her work about art restoration. So do watch it and do share it with everyone. So here we go. Hi, Sana. How are you?
Hello, Mehreen. I'm fine. Thank you so much for inviting me here. And I'm really... Yeah, I'm excited. Thanks. Because it's been a long time we met.
So. Yeah, exactly. We have met also. And we have, me and yes. Sana have worked also. Thank you for your time and coming online. And we had another video of your work we have been watching. So finally, we are having you on live. So you are from, where did you start from your education as an artist? Can you give us a bit of background of your work?
Yeah, actually, basically... from where to start? Okay, let me see. Okay, I obtained my master's in fine arts painting from Punjab University, and after that I did my second master's in MPhil from Beacon House National University in 2016. Mm-hmm. Since then I'm working in the field of visual artist and also art restoration and conservation. But let me just tell you a little about how this art restoration journey started for me, because basically it was also a very new thing for me when I started learning, and it's kind of a process which involves the use of different techniques and solvents to treat, preserve, renovate and repair the damages which occurs to artworks like paintings, drawings, prints, sculptures and other art objects to bring back to its original appearance as much as possible. And the main goal is to save the value of an artwork and to protect them from future damages and deterioration. Mm-hmm. So that is the main thing which needs to be done in the field of this conservation and restoration. And that's why I'm just limiting myself to the field of conservation of painting, because it's a huge and vast field. Yeah. One cannot explore it, because you have a metal restoration, you have a, I mean, there are different objects. It's not just about the restoration of painting. You have paper conservation, you have metal conservation and wood conservation. So there are several fields inside this field of conservation. So yeah, that's why I'm trying to just focus myself on the field in which I'm most interested in. And I do have the background of studying painting, and I've done painting as my major. So that's why it was very beneficial for me to carry it in the field of painting restoration.
Okay. And how did you start it from doing your master's to, you know, you must be trained as a painter in the beginning, right?
Yes. Yes, exactly. And in 2016, I was selected in a conservation and restoration workshop. It was a project offered by Danish Center for Cultural and Development in collaboration with Alhambra Art Council, Lahore Art Council. Along with other participants, I worked on the masterpieces of some of the great master painters of Pakistan, which includes Ustad Allah Bakhsh, Sadiq Khan, S. Safdar, Saeed Akhtar, and many more. Usme agar ek aap painting wahan dekhen, it's the part of the permanent collection of Alhambra Art Museum, jo Sony Mahewal ki hai, ek painting on display. I've also worked on that painting. And then I realized that, okay, this is what I want to do. And I developed my interest from that time. Since then, I've been working within the field of conservation and restoration of oil paintings, especially. Where I was given another project of one of the famous painting by legendary artist Anna Malka Ahmed from the permanent collection of Alhambra Art Museum, Lahore. But it all happened after the completion of the project, the restoration project. It was a 3 months long course, which we did. And along with other participants, I was selected amongst best 10 art restorers by Sir Martin Bernstead, who came here to teach us this very interesting course, or the workshop, you say. And this painting, I just want to give you a little explanation about the painting. Is this painting by Anna Molka is from the permanent collection of Alhambra Art Museum, and it's titled Tariq Bin Ziyad in Vision of Spain. I've already shared the images with you, and still in the process.
We have a whole video about the details of the project. Sorry to interrupt you, but I was mentioning that we have a whole. If you want to know more, so you can watch that video. I was talking to the audience.
Actually, basically, it's near to the completion, but there were many other projects and things which I was also doing throughout this work, and because it was a challenging project for me due to the extreme damages of the painting and required advanced skills and expertise, which was the reason and compelled me to get further professional restoration trainings. And for this purpose, then I went for an international restoration course independently from Florence, Italy in 2019, which was conducted by a very well-known Italian art restorer, Mrs. Eliana Gianetti, who specifically works on the paintings of Pisa. And she was very kind and humble to teach me this course, because I went there, I spoke to her, and she, मजे की बात ये है कि she didn't know English at all. और हमने बीच में प्रियो का I hired a translator to translate everything whatever she was teaching me, and the translator was supposed to tell me, okay, what does she mean? And the translator herself was very much excited to learn that, okay, I myself am learning, her statement was to me. Mm-hmm. And I said, okay, I'm glad that you're also learning in this process, because this is very engaging process for the person or the people who are interested to do it. On my return, then I got two more projects to work on. Uske saath ye hai ki I also wanted to continue my art practice, and I also exhibited my work in different galleries after my on my return. But and or in 2019, early 2019, I also did my solo show. So मुझे लगा कि अब थोड़ा सा इसमें मेरे पास ब्रेक है टू एक्सप्लोर दिस एंड टू इनहांस माय एक्सपर्टीज इन द फील्ड ऑफ रेस्टोरेशन एज वेल. तो उसके बाद जो दो प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं, वन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट वाज विद हंगेरियन एम्बेसी, एंड आई थिंक यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस प्रिंसेस बाम्बाज कलेक्शन ऑगस्ट चक्ट पेंटिंग्स रेस्टोरेशन प्रोजेक्ट. द पेंटिंग इट वाज द प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ 11 पेंटिंग to be restored by the artist August Schott, and they are being displayed at Sikh Gallery at Lahore Fort right now. But we are done with the project. There were five Hungarian art restorers who came from Hungary, and I was their field project manager and a restorer, and I worked with them on the project for 3 months. So it was also a very interesting experience for me, because the training I got from Florence was something which was very related to traditional aspect of restoration. Like, she was using all the traditional material and solvents to treat the paintings. But the things I learned from Hungarian restorers were they were using modern skills and trainings and solvents and chemicals to treat the paintings. So I got the knowledge of both sides, and then I compare and implement my own style of doing painting conservation now. And it's all because of the learning from two different aspects that I'm now able to explore more. And I think that I'm still learning. It's not just, it's a never ending process, I guess, from me. And I think it happens in every field, learning process. Yeah. You learn your whole life, and you just want to improve the way you're doing your work.
No, learning has to go on. So what you have, like you have mentioned one painting of Anna Molka Ahmad. What other paintings that you have restored so far?
Yeah, basically, these two projects were so engaging because I just got free from another project. The first project was with Hungarian Embassy, and the second project was with ICROM for Collegia. And I was selected last year for their international course on rethinking disaster risk management for saving cultural heritage. Okay. Now, this was something which was related to the field of conservation, but it's not directly. It's just kind of the restoration conservation field comes under the umbrella of this disaster risk management planning. That was my understanding. So that's why I completed the course, and yesterday I was graduated finally. And now I'm also thinking to, because I also got this opportunity and offer to teach this disaster risk management course in a college. So yeah, basically I was engaged in many things, and there are just 2 to 3 projects of restoration which I'm doing right now, and also doing some getting a private work as well, which I got. So this is all which I've done all these years. Yeah.
So I have to, like, you know, when we dig deeper, it's is this a tedious, very tedious, it sounds like a very tedious job to restore it, and there is a lot of responsibility as well. How do you manage that?
It's a tedious job. Every job is tedious for the person who is not interested to do it.
Exactly.
You know, this is my understanding. Because if you are engaged in a process, if you love doing what you are doing, then I think there is no time to get tired of. Mm-hmm. And on my return from Florence, when I came back, I started doing the painting at Al Hamrat Museum again. It was kind of an easy task, because when I came back on my return, I was trying to apply the techniques, the proper techniques which I learned from there. So that's why it's taking time, and I didn't get time to get more things, and I was not like, so it's not about being I never got bored with this work. I never had this feeling that, okay, I'm tired, I don't want to do this anymore. So nothing like that happened for me, especially in this field of restoration. Because whenever I feel like there is something going on somewhere related to restoration, I'm super excited and I want to jump in. So this is what...
So are you associated with one organization, or you are working with different people?
No, I'm not associated. I was associated with one organization, which is Al Hamra Art Council. And I am still on their project. But there are other organizations as well. I'm also associated to World City in different aspects. Like, there are huge projects which I'm interested to do. But let's see. And I'm also associated to, there are different organizations which I'm also interested to work with them in later stages.
And you are an artist also. You produce your own work. You exhibit your work. We have work together as well. We have met, I remember. Mm-hmm. But have you worked together as well? Have you displayed with
me?
Have you displayed with me also?
Yes. What? Yes.
You did.
Once, when you were in Lahore.
Oh, yes.
There was a group show.
We have displayed together. So you have spaces in your work, you know, when we see your work. So there are spaces. And it's in kind of relief form as well. There's a lot happening. So what's your inspiration and where does it come from?
See, this is a very interesting question you've asked, because I think and I feel that my whole journey of conservation and restoration started from my artworks. And this was... my solo show in 2019, which gave me more clarity about the connection between the restoration of painting and my artwork, because I was also working with spaces, with abandoned spaces, and my intention was to engage the viewer or treat the spaces so that they are preserved. So that's why the title of my solo show was also Preserving the Preserved. So it is strongly connected to my art practice, this field of restoration. And I think this was the way for taking my restoration work further, that I was so much engaged with spaces, with abandoned spaces, and I was treating them to preserve them, to restore them in a way. So it compelled me to jump into this field of painting restoration. So they are very much connected. You have seen my work, so you can also relate that how strongly they are connected to each other. So this was also another finding for me. This was not which I was aware of. It is kind of a natural process which goes during your art practice when you are engaged in your work. I can't hear you, Marine. You're muted, I guess. No, sorry. Yes.
Hear me now?
No.
So thank
Yes.
you so much. Would you like to add something more to it for, because there is not we don't see many art restorers in Pakistan. So if they want to pursue as a career or join this field as well, it's like a new dimension for a lot of people who are watching, or youngsters who want to be an artist, and a lot of art lovers as well. So what's your advice in that regard?
Well, as far as your not question, as far as this finding is that there are no such restorers, actually there are many conservators and restorers working, but unfortunately we don't have any professional degree because this is the basic requirement for the timing that, and Pakistan government has been supporting many such projects, but there is an urgent need of developing professional expertise for which it can support further by taking initiatives like offering trainings and workshops of international standards for dedicated people, which may lead to academic interest for from art institutions for setting up academic programs in the field. And a fully function conservation and restoration lab is also very much required. Although I was also working on establishing one, but let's see how it
Hopefully.
works, because this is my planning. My future plans are also related to work in the field in a way that it should be beneficial for our society as well, and also for the people or the artists who are interested to take art restoration as a career. So whatever, and you know what, there was another thing. When I went to Florence on my return, I also took a step of inviting the same lady, my teacher over there, my the art restorer. I wanted to invite her here and wanted to give her a training workshop to all the interested people or artists who are unable to go there or who find it difficult to manage it. So I was trying to create a platform here as well, but because of this lockdown and situation and the COVID situation, it's still in the process. And let's see when we will get a feasible environment to invite her here. So, yeah.
All the best for that, Sana,
Thank
and
you.
thank you. We learned a lot about
Thank
art restoration today and about your work as well. So thank you so much for your time, and thanks for being there. And those who are watching, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe to my channel. Share it with your fellow artists and students and other people who are art lovers. We are posting every week, so don't forget to hit on the notification bell. And if you want to know more about Sana's work, there is a video on art restoration, and her bio is also mentioned in the description below. So you can see that, you can follow her on Instagram and see her work and see what she's doing. I'll invite her again because there is more work coming up, and we are following. We have been doing this for a while now, and we have been following each other for a while now for this art restoration project, and which was very interesting as well. And we wish you all the best. Thank you, and
Thank
take
you
care.
so much. Thank you so much, Mehreen, for inviting me again. And I just want to add one thing here. I don't use Instagram that often, but mostly I use Facebook. But I'm trying to get used to of Instagram again because I just post a few things there. But yes, in future I do have plans to use it more often, and I'll be also posting my work there. So thank you so much, and
You're most welcome.
take
We
care.
would love to see you work. So take care, everyone. Love us.
Take care. Bye bye. Allah Hafiz.
Bye-bye.